Good day, students. Welcome to math.serve.com. In this clip, we're going to be going over how to solve radical equations. So let's take a look at question number one. For problem one, we're to solve the radical equation, the cube root of t minus 2 equals 2. So the task here is to isolate t in this radical equation. So this can be carried out by executing two algebraic steps. The first one involves getting rid of the cube root, and then secondly, getting rid of the negative 2. After getting rid of the cube root and negative 2 in that order, you'll be left with t, and your equation would have been solved. Okay, so let's go ahead and execute the steps. So we're going to use the inverse of the cube root, and we know that the inverse of root is power. So the inverse of the third root is the third power. So what does that mean? Well, it simply means we will be taking the third power of both sides of the equation in order to eliminate the cube root from the left side of the equation. Okay? All right, so let's go ahead and apply that idea to this equation. So you notice I have cubed both sides of the equation. The goal again is to get rid of this cube root by making use of its inverse, which is the cubed, or the third power. So what happens on the left side of the equation? Well, the inverse operations neutralize each other. So the cube of the cube root, they cancel out. So you're left with t minus 2. Now on the right side, we have 2 to the third power. So we multiply 2 by itself 3 times, and you get 8. Okay? Now we've used the inverse of the root to get rid of the radical piece. Now we'll simply isolate t by adding 2 to both sides. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. If we add 2 to both sides, you end up with t equals 10. And we can do a real quick mental check to verify the accuracy of our result. If you plug in 10 into t, you will have 10 minus 2, which is 8, and the cube root of 8 is 2, because 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. So we are confident that our answer is in fact correct. Now let's take a look at the next question. All right, so for problem 2, we are to solve the equation, the square root of 10, x plus 10, equals 5 minus the square root of 3 minus x. So the ultimate goal is to eliminate the radicals, okay, and then solve the resulting algebraic equation. So how do we go about eliminating the radicals? Well, you notice we have one radical isolated on the left side. So by squaring both sides of the equation, we can eliminate that radical. And then we'll proceed to isolate this radical on the right side and eliminate that also by squaring both sides of the equation. So let's eliminate the radical on the left side by squaring both sides of the equation first. So we square it in that order. On the left side, the square root and square are inverse operations as carried out in step in problem one. So here we have twos, they cancel each other out. But on the right side of the equation, we have the difference of two quantities. So we're going to be using the distribution or FOIL methods to expand the right side of this equation. So if we apply the procedure, we'll have on the left side the squares, the square and the square root cancel out. And on the right side, we're going to use this shortcut. The reason why we're using the shortcut here is to save time. But if this shortcut is too abstract for you, you can simply write this quantity twice and then distribute. Okay, so this is the fast way of squaring the difference or sum of binomials. Okay, so if we apply that idea here, a is 5, b is the square root of 3 minus x. So if we do a squared, that'll be 5 squared. 2ab is 2 times 5 times the square root of 3 minus x plus b squared, which is plus the square root of 3 minus x squared. Okay? All right, so if we simplify this, what you notice is on the right side, we are squaring a square root again, so that cancels each other out. So that leaves us with x plus 10 following the order of operations. We have 25 minus 10 root 3 minus x plus 3 minus x. Okay, now what is our goal? Our goal is to isolate this squared quantity again and eliminate it. All right, eliminate the square root so we can solve the resulting algebraic equation. So to do that, we're going to have to move 25 and 3 minus x to the left side of the equation. So if we do that, we add x to both sides, subtract 3 and subtract 25. Minus 3 minus 25 is the same thing as minus 28. Simplify. We have 2x minus 18 equals negative 10 times the square root of 3 minus x. Now I can divide both sides by negative 10, but that will give me an unpleasant fraction on the left side. So let's leave 10 on the right side. Okay? Remember, the goal was to eliminate this square root right here. So to accomplish that, we're going to use the inverse of the square root, which is the square. So we're going to square both sides of the equation. And then we're going to use the same formula that we discussed earlier on the left side to expand this difference of two terms. And that yields a squared, which is 2x squared, minus 2ab, 2 times a, which is 2x times b, which is 18, plus b squared, which is 18 squared. On the right side, what we'll do is distribute this 2 to 10 and this squared root quantity. So if we do that, we will have negative 10 squared times the square root of 3 minus x squared. Simplifying the left side of our equation, we will have 4x squared minus 72x plus 324. On the right side, if we square negative 10, we have 100, and then this square root and square cancel out. All right, so now we're going to write this resulting equation in a form where we can solve it. Okay, So let's distribute this 100 to these two terms in this quantity on the right. So we will have 44x squared minus 72x plus 324 equals 300 minus 100x. Now this is a quadratic equation. So how do you go about solving quadratic equations? You put them in standard form. So for standard form, you want the degree in descending order and it's set equal to 0. All right, so to accomplish that, we're going to add 100x to both sides and subtract 300, okay? So if we do that, we'll have 4x squared plus 28x plus 24 equals 0. Now this is the standard form of a quadratic equation, but can this equation be reduced? If so, we should reduce it because it makes the work easier. So what's the greatest common factor here? The greatest common factor is 4. So we factor out 4 from all three terms. This is what we'll have. And then divide both sides by 4. And your final answer will be x squared plus 7x plus 6. That equals 0. So this is the reduced standard form of the equation of a quadratic. Okay, now to solve this, we are simply going to factor. So let's use the x game or the AC method. AC goes on top, B goes on the bottom. AC is 6 times 1, which is 6. B is 7. All right, so what two numbers multiply to give you 6 and add to give you 7? We have 6 and 1. It worked perfectly. 6 times 1 is 6. 6 plus 1 is 7. Now we'll replace the middle term with those two numbers. Break it down the center, factor by grouping. Factor out x from the first two and 1 from the second two. And you have x plus 1 times x plus 6 equals 0. Now we'll use the zero product property to finish off this equation. So what we'll do now is set both factors to 0. X plus 1 equals 0. Subtract 1 from both sides. X equals negative 1. X plus 6, set that equals to 0. Subtract 6 from both sides. And then you have x equals negative 6. So these are the answers to the radical equation. Now, are these two answers visible? Are they actually the answers? Now, anytime you are squaring both sides of a radical equation, there's a possibility that you might introduce extraneous solutions. So these two might be the answer, one of them might be the answer, or none of them are the answers. So how do we know if these are answers to the original radical equation? We'll simply have to do a check, okay? So let's go ahead and do that. So anytime you are solving radical equations that involve squaring both sides, you always want to do a check, okay? So let's check x equals negative 1. What we'll do is plug negative 1 into x in the original problem. So if we do so, the question now is this a true statement? We'll simply simplify this equation using the order of operations. So we have the square root of 9 plus 5 is the square root of 9 equals to 5 minus the square root of 4. Simplify further. Square root of 9 is 3. Square root of 4 is 2. Is 3 equal to 5 minus 2? The answer is yes. Okay, now we check the next solution. Remember, you have to check all the solutions you get to ensure that they are not extraneous. So what do we do here? We plug in negative 6 into all the x's in the original problem. Okay, just as we did when we were checking x equals negative 1. Let's go ahead and simplify this. We'll have the square root of 4 equals 5 minus the square root of 9. Is 2 equals 5 minus 3? Absolutely. So we can see that our two answers are in fact correct. Okay? So our solutions are negative 1 and 6. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other tutorials such as this. And if you have any questions about this problem or any videos you would like us to make, please include that in the comments section below. You can give us a thumbs up if you like this tutorial or you would like to support us. More clips can be found on math.serve.com. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.